There's an Arabic saying, Cairo writes, Beirut prints, and Baghdad reads.
For centuries, Al-Mutanabbi Street has been the beating heart of Iraq's literary community. Named after a 10th century Iraqi poet, the street is lined with bookstores, publishing houses, and outdoor bookstores. Dating back to the Ottoman Empire, the street's story is just as captivating as any book for sale. It has survived years of war, censorship, and dictatorship, and recovered from a terrorist attack in 2007 that killed around 30 people and injured hundreds more. Friday is the busiest day here. Intellects and writers come from across the country to discover new manuscripts and discuss their work. Poet Saeed Al-Rodhan has been coming here since he was a young man.
And I, as a person interested in culture, attend the street during the 70s, first time. And now I published my books in the street. And we can say it is the vein of Iraqi culture.
Adahem Adal is an emerging poet with a shop on the street. Passionate about political and social justice, he has published 5 books on the subject. His words cost him 3 months in prison.
There is an expression, an old expression, that said, if you want to be a poet, just be an Iraqi man. So I found that poetry really can change people, can change their minds, can change their thoughts, can change their ideologies. Because we are people, in spite of all the violence, we have a goodness in our deep heart. We are good people and we are peaceful.
Like many authors, Adahem believes that the love for literature is embedded deep into Iraq society. The country's second largest city, Mosul, sits on the crossroads of ancient trading routes and for centuries boasted a parade of bookshops and libraries along Al-Janafi Street. But when the so-called Islamic State group entered the city in the summer of 2014, the group methodically destroyed libraries and burned books.
It's hard to believe that this street here was once the cultural hub of Mosul, with libraries and bookshops lining the street and people from across Iraq coming to share the spirit of the city.
For as long as Osama can remember, his family has owned a bookshop on the street.
The street was stable and it was the heart of the city and it was always crowded with people from morning until night. Then when problems started and ISIS entered, slowly problems erupted in it. People started talking less and things like that. And so it got quieter. Instability and discomfort, things like that.
During the battle to retake the city from the terrorist organization, Al-Janafi Street was completely destroyed. It took Osama over a year to rebuild his store and reopen. Just 4 months after the liberation of Mosul, Fahad Al-Ghaburi opened the Book Forum, a cultural cafe in East Mosul. The engineer turned entrepreneur felt the only way for people to heal from the traumas of war was to rebuild the city's culture. Now Iraqis gather to openly debate literature, music and politics, things once banned. The cafe also hosts a female writers' club. For these young women, books were their sanctuary during the occupation. With literature no longer on sale, a secret library of electronic books emerged. USBs filled with PDF manuscripts popped up on the black market.
In the time of ISIS, there was fear that we might die at any minute. That is why I decided to travel somewhere else. So I traveled through books, reading, or writing. We almost spent our entire day doing this, to the point where I created a second world without internet nor TV. I didn't care whether they were available or not. I didn't care about the war anymore and I stopped being scared of it because of reading and writing. To bury yourself in books?
Wow, this is amazing.
Brought together by their passion for words, these aspiring authors believe that the peace for their city lies in literacy. With Iraqis now turning a page on the more turbulent times, arguably a new chapter filled with hope and culture awaits.